Okay, so when you multiply decimals, which is lesson 1.02, you're going to multiply just like you normally do, ignoring the decimal point at the beginning part. Okay, so this is one of the examples. So we have, and I believe it's money, yes, $3.79 times 6.5. Okay, so I'm just going to do multiplication like I have always done multiplication, ignoring the decimal point at the moment. So 5 times 9 is 45. 5 times 7 is 35 plus 4 is 39. 5 times 3 is 15 plus 3 is 18. I'm going to move to my tens position. 6 times 9 is 54. 6 times 7 is 42 plus 5 is 47. 6 times 3 is 18 plus 4 is 22. Okay, so now I'm going to add these two together just like I always do. 5 plus nothing is 5. 9 plus 4 is 13. 7 plus 8 is 15 and 1 is 16. 1 and 1 is 2, plus 2 is 4, and nothing plus 2 is 2. Okay, so here's my answer. Now I need to go back up to my original problem and count up how many decimal place positions were there. So here's 1, 2, 3. So currently your decimal point is right here. So we're going to move it to the left 3 spots. 1, 2, 3. So your answer would be 24.635. Okay, so that's how you're going to multiply using or multiply numbers with decimals in them. Okay, so then dividing numbers with decimals. Which is lesson 1.03. So let's say if we have 3.2 divided into 147.2. Okay. Now your divisor, you need to move the decimal place as many times to the right as you need to so that this becomes a whole number. So in this case, with 3.2, I only need to move it one place. So this now becomes 32. However many times you move the decimal place here, you have to do it here as well. So I'm going to move it one place here. So this number now becomes 1,472. Okay, because your decimal point is now after the 2 in both numbers. And then you just divide like we always have. So 32 goes into 147 four times. 4 times 32 is 128. We would subtract, that is 19. Bring down your 2. 32 goes into 192 six times. 6 times 32 is 192. When we subtract, we have 0. Okay. Let me separate these two. So here is your answer, and your decimal point would just go straight up, which there isn't anything beyond the decimal point. It's a whole number. Now, in some cases, your decimal point might be in your answer still. So let's take a look at 2.5. Let me scoot it up just a little bit. 2.5 divided into 1.48. Okay. So in the 2.5, we need to move it one place to make it a whole number. So it would become 25. So we're going to move our decimal point one place in the 1.48, which would make it 14.8. Okay. Now, when you still have a decimal point here, it's going to go straight up, okay? And then we just divide like normal. 25 goes into 148 five times, and as you notice, it's already to the right of my decimal point. 5 times 25 is 125. We're going to subtract, and that's 23. 25 cannot go into 23, but because we're using decimals, we can add a zero here, bring the zero down. But so now we're going to do 25 into 230, which would be 9. 9 times 25 is 225. Subtract 230 minus 225, we get 5. So I'm going to add another zero to bring down. 25 goes into 52 times. 2 times 25 is 50. And we're left with zero. So your answer is 0.592. Okay, so that's how you're going to add and subtract, multiply and divide with decimal points.